San Diego's Jazz 88.3. The music there from Wadado, Leo Smith, and the Great Lakes Suites. The top of our guest this evening, Robert Bush's list of best of 2014. Welcome back to the New Jazz Thing. Robert, thanks for being with us tonight.
It's my pleasure, Vincent.
So was Henry Threadgill just playing everything all at the same time right then?
He was playing flute mostly on that one. But that's one of the things I really love about this disc is they play in the quartet mode for a while, and then things will morph into a duet of drums and reeds or bass and trumpet. So it's very creative the way it modulates, let's say, from one thing to the other.
I think morph was a good word there, too. Well, so we've been chatting a little bit with Robert about his best of 2014 list, which is posted out on the blog post for tonight's show. We've got a link to it published out on All About Jazz. Great to have San Diego's premier jazz journalist published in one of the premier websites about jazz, allaboutjazz.com. Congratulations, Robert, about that, that you're being published out there. Is that a good thing for you, part of your career track?
Well, the great thing about it is that it's got an incredible reach, because it's a global kind of thing. So I think article that's gotten the most play for me has been my interview with Bertram Turetsky.
Nice.
Which has, I think, like over 18,000 reads. Because people can reference this any time, my articles are averaging at about 10,000 people that are reading them. So that's great to have that kind of output, for the world at large.
And as long as you keep plugging San Diego artists, that's great. We'll keep you to that. So let's talk about 2015, looking forward. And I would imagine we'll probably see some articles about this, some reviews, some of these things coming up in the year. But let's just start at the top. We talked a little bit about the Jeff Denson, Joshua White release from 2014, the I'll Fly Away disc. But you say this is the year that Joshua White goes global. Tell us what you mean by that.
Well, I should say that I believe that this year is going to be a breakout year for Joshua. I don't know. Some folks are aware that last year he did a short California tour with Jeff Denson, bassist Jeff Denson, and the legendary alto saxophonist Lee Konitz. And I'm quite sure that anyone who had the pleasure of being able to attend those shows, especially since a lot of them, I'm sure, showed up to see Lee Konitz, mm-hmm. the exposure that he got from that gig, I think, is going to really make an impression on people. And as well as I believe that I can't imagine that he didn't make a huge impression on Lee Konitz himself. So, he's still unsigned for a record deal, but there are people who are definitely expressing interest in that. I'd love to see him get signed to somebody with some pull, like ECM. That would just totally make my life, that would be so great. But the great thing about Joshua is that he's not waiting for these opportunities. He's creating his opportunities. He's continuing to move forward. And so just in the first part of this year, he's going to be debuting a couple of new groups. He has one called Polyphase, which I imagine is going to be sort of a funk jazz kind of thing. That's with Stephen McKinney on bass, Greg McKinney on drums, Curtis Taylor on trumpet, and a special guest, vocalist Rebecca Jade, who I absolutely love. And they're going to be playing at The Loft on February 13th. In April, he's debuting a new quintet at Dizzy's on April 18th with Stephanie Richards on trumpet, who just joined the UCSD staff, and I've heard amazing things about her. And then one of my favorite musicians of all time, Ellen Weller, will be on reeds. And rounding out the group will be the fabulous Mark Dresser and Shell Nordison, who came here to get his doctorate. I think I believe he came from Sweden, but he's a guy that has a global reputation himself, and he's rapidly becoming one of my favorite drummers of all time.
And he was featured in several shows this year, here in San Diego at the Loft and elsewhere.
Right, and he's got a solo performance coming up in Bonnie Wright's Fresh Sound series on May 1st. He's going to do a solo percussion thing. The great thing about Shell is he plays drums and vibraphone, marimba, and orchestral percussion and all that stuff. But to round out my beliefs about Joshua White, in the fall of this year, he's going to be touring with the very well-known saxophonist Rudresh Mahanthapa, and who just put out a brand new album called Bird Calls, which is Rudresh's homage to Charlie Parker, but it's done in Rudresh Mahanthapa style. So he's taking tunes that were inspired by bird songs and interpreting him in his own way. This is going to get a lot of recognition. I imagine it's going to be in a lot of people's best of 2015 lists. And on the record, he has a pretty well-known New York pianist, Matt Mitchell. But Joshua will be joining, will be taking that chair and touring Europe with Rudresh Mahanthapa's Bird Calls group, which also features the amazing bassist Francois Mouton, trumpeter Adam O'Farrell, and the great New York City drummer Rudy Royston. So that's happening in the fall. And I just think that the more people that get the opportunity to hear Joshua, the better the world is going to become.
We hope that that he goes to Europe and actually comes back and doesn't just stay somewhere else there. Let's talk a little bit. We just heard music from the Wadada Leo Smith, one of the top discs of 2014. Actually, Robert's and he's coming into town next week here and is playing with Anthony Davis. Any quick thoughts on what you're expecting to see out of that show?
Yeah, I'm glad you reminded me of that. That this is it's going to be on the January 21st. It's part of UCSD's Wednesday at 7 series. So that'll be in Conrad Prebys, the recital hall, I believe. And I just can't recommend this enough, because the opportunity to see Wadada Leo Smith is, it's something to be treasured. I just had that opportunity in September. I drove up to L.A. to see Wadada Leo Smith's Silver Orchestra along with Anthony Braxton's trio. That was really fantastic. I think they're going to be doing some of the same music. And in addition to our own local treasure, Anthony Davis, this guy might be San Diego's best kept secret, but I remember him being sort of media focused a lot of attention on him when I was like 19 or 20 years old. He sort of preceded Wynton Marsalis and that group as the young lions of the day. And I'll never forget seeing him in La Jolla at the La Jolla Jazz Festival back in the day with a group. So we're so lucky that he accepted a position at UCSD and is part of our community. And he doesn't play enough around town, so I'm really excited about that. I believe they will be accompanied by a chamber orchestra of UCSD grad students. Mm. So in addition to being able to see Odalio Smith and Anthony Davis, you'll be able to see some of the people we've got queued up in San Diego to take the world by storm.
Well, we'll have to put a link out on tonight's blog post to that show, because that's coming up really quick next week. So I want to make sure that we get a full house out there for that. Come on. It's one of the biggest artists of the year last year in town here playing with San Diego artists. So let's quickly kind of end things with what's happening with our favorite bassist in town. Well, one of our favorite bassists in town. One of the most inventive, and an artist who was featured as a clinician and performer at the recent Jazz Education Network conference that just finished here in San Diego. He was did a session about telematics at the conference. Mark Dresser, there's a week coming up that you think is going to be just extra special. Tell us about that.
Yeah, well, you know, Mark Dresser is a dear friend and a guy who I've been watching carefully for over 30 years, and he lived in New York for 18 years before he came back to San Diego to take a position at UCSD. So Mark Dresser is doing a one-week residency at the a club called The Stone in New York City. And so every night he's going to be playing in a different configuration. He starts it off playing solo, and then he's going to have performances with Trio M, which is with Myra Melford and Matt Wilson, another group called CDE, which stands for Andrew Cyril, Mark Dresser, and Marty Ehrlich. He's going to play some duos with Diane Moser, the incredible legendary Roswell Rudd, trombonist, and a quartet with Ray Anderson and Earl Howard and Peter Evans. He also is going to debut a group, or not debut, but a feature a group called Deep Tones for Peace, which is a large bass choir that is their raison d'etre is to make a political statement for peace in the Middle East. And this is going to feature legendary Rufus Reed, Brad Jones, Mark Elias, Lindsey Horner.
Wow.
William Parker, possibly, and a couple of other folks. So about eight or nine basses playing search of deep peace. Also, Mark May, he has a couple of local appearances. He may be a part of Adam Rudolph's Go Organic Orchestra on February 25th, and on February 2nd, he's going to appear just for the last tune with this fantastic vocalist, multi-instrumentalist, Jin Shu, and those will both be at the Loft at UCSD, so keep an eye on that.
Wow, so it sounds like Mark has got a full week there, and I would expect, Robert, you're going to have a full week there of writing about multiple shows and all of that. Any other projects that you have in particular that you're going to be working on, writing? What are you doing for the rest of 2015? You're an educator also here at San Diego City College, at least you have been. What else are you doing?
Well, this year, my goal is to find someone to publish some really expanded pieces. I want to do articles like 5-10,000 words, mm-hmm. and I'm something that really can give the details about so many of San Diego artists. I mean, I could do one of these a week for 52 weeks and not run out of material, because there's so many people here that deserve the attention. Like I was mentioning, Anthony Davis, right. And Kamau Kenyatta, Mark Dresser, Mike Wofford. I mean, that's just you know...
Yeah, the beginning of a list.
The beginning of a long list. So I'm hoping to have some opportunities to do that. In March, I've got a couple of pieces coming out in the Reader. One about the jazz scene in general, and another about UCSD and the experimental music scene, which will also focus on my friend Bonnie Wright's concert series that she produces called Fresh Sound, which brings people to San Diego that you would just never get the opportunity to hear. And it's been a fantastic series. And again, it's something I've been experiencing for 20 or 30 years. Mm-hmm. And also, I would like to take this opportunity to wish my granddaughter, Sarah Jordan, who's lives in Houston, Texas. She's going to be 14 years old on the 14th of this month, so on Wednesday she will be 14. I just want to say happy birthday, baby, and I love you and I miss you, and that's about it.
That's great. That's what the worldwide reach of Jazz 88 can do for you, among other things. Robert, we're going to close tonight with a piece from another disc that made it to your Best of 2014 list and was just added this week to the Jazz 88 library, so folks are going to be hearing more of it. It's the Keith Jarrett, Charlie Hayden, Paul Motion disc, Hamburg 72. We're going to play a piece called Peace for Ornette, which you helped us pick out. Tell us a little bit about the disc and the tune before we head
out. Oh, well, you know, this is another one that it blew me away when ECM made this available, because I love Keith Jarrett. He's one of my favorite musicians of all time. I loved that trio that he had with Hayden and Motion, which was quite some time ago. And you would have thought by now that all the material that they had recorded would have long been available. I believe I have every disc that they ever made, including the quartet that they had, which added Dewey Redman. So when ECM announced that this was going to be available, I couldn't have been more excited, and it was number two on my list, and I'll stand by that assessment.
Excellent. Well, Robert, do you have a website, a blog, or where can folks? What's the best way to folks connect with you and read your writing?
Well, I write online for a lot of publications, so you can go to the sandiegoreader.com, go to the music, and you'll type in my name, and you can see I have like 400 or 500 articles there. I also write for NBC San Diego, which if you go to nbcsandiego.com, scroll down to the section called Sound Diego, that's their stuff on music, and I have quite a few things there, as well as All About Jazz, and hopefully this year I'll be adding more publications, getting the word out, and reaching more people.
Excellent. Well, Robert, thank you so much for hanging with us tonight on the New Jazz Thing. Looking forward to 2015 and seeing you around here at the station and reading your work online and in print everywhere. Thanks so much, Robert.
You're welcome.
From Keith Jarrett, Charlie Hayden, Paul Motion, Hamburg 72, this is Peace for Ornette. On the New Jazz Thing, San Diego's Jazz 88.3. All right.
That's Jarrett playing soprano, not piano.
Excellent. All right.
Okay.